get crazy, get wild. Let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun, then do something. If you wanna have fun, then do something. Get crazy, get wild. Let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun, then do something. 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 So today I walk into class and you know, I see my homie Wyatt and I say, what's up? And he says, sup. What's up? Sup? Like, are you for real? Like, do you hate me? Do you want me like gone? Do you want me to like, what's the problem? Like, I'm so confused. He's just acting all brand new, acting like he don't know me. He don't know anything about me. And that's just not cool. That's not cool at all.
What's up? I said sup when Vita walked into class today, and she was just tripping for no reason. Had all the types of negative energy. She was knocking down chairs. Knocking down tables. Knocking over people. Knocking over all types of stuff. It's just weird.
I just like don't understand why he acts like this with me whenever all I've done is been nice to him and just be sweet. And he acts like we're not friends or anything, and like just acts like I'm not cool enough for him or something like that, but it's whatever. Yeah.
Good morning, Clear Falls. I'm Jill Sanchez.
And I'm Michaela Anding.
And welcome to Night Vision.
Let's get you started with your need to know info.
Seniors, don't forget to purchase your prom tickets. Tickets will be on sale from now until April 5th for $75. After April 8th, tickets will be sold for $90 through April 12th on Friday. No tickets will be sold at the door. You'll need to have your prom clearance form completed before you can purchase your ticket. Visit any house secretary to pick up a prom clearance form before visiting the bookkeeper to buy your tickets.
Attention teachers, don't forget to stop by the library this week and bid on amazing student artwork. The starting bid is only $5 and proceeds benefit CCISD Senior Art Scholarships and the National Art Society. Bidding closes at 12:30 this Friday. Don't miss out.
Ready to laugh? Come out this Friday to the improv show. Tickets are just $5 and show starts at 7 p.m. We look forward to seeing you there. Also, come support your favorite comedic nights as they compete this Saturday at Clear Springs High School in the district improv show. The competition begins at 7 p.m. and tickets will cost $5. Let's show CCISD what Clear Falls is made of.
Hey seniors, want to see yourself in the 2019 Senior Slideshow? Then attach and submit up to 3 pictures in an email and send it to clearfallsnightvision@gmail.com. Pictures will be accepted now until Friday, April 12th. See the Night Vision Room in House 4 for more info.
Do you have something to say? Are you a senior or want to be quoted? Seniors, the Light Life newspaper magazine needs your opinion. If you would like to see senior quotes in the Night Life edition, then visit tinyurl.com/CFHS senior poll and fill out the survey.
The next STAR tutorial will be on Monday, April 1st in the library. Come to the library from 2:45 to 4:30 for help to get ready for the English STAR exams. There will be snacks and the bus will bring you home.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is your newest episode of How to Make New Friends in today's cruel world of high school. I'm just kidding, it's not that cool, it's pretty fun. But today I'm going to be teaching you how to make your new best friends. And, you know, friends for life. Everyone needs friends. Because if you have friends, you can have friends for life. And then that friend for life may turn into a wife. For life. Step one on how to make new friends. Whenever you meet someone, you always want to make sure you introduce yourself. You don't just introduce yourself normally. You're not like, hello, my name is Jordan Rauscher. You know, that's kind of boring. You always want to scream like this.
Hi, Hi.
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 Oh my God.
Hi.
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 Step two, always look them in the eyes. Step three, always shake someone's hand for an acceptable amount of time.
Hello there. Hi.
That's aggressive.
Because if you don't shake their hand, you're like, hello, what's up? Maybe do that with your friends, but these are new friends. You're trying to make new friends. With old friends, you can be like, what's up, dude? How's it going, homie? You say stuff like that. Step four, find common interests.
Hey there.
Hi.
What are you interested in?
I'm really interested in my Lord and Savior, Toast Malone.
Toasty Malone.
Toasty Malone.
I like it.
If you don't have anything in common with someone, it's probably you're not gonna like them very much because they're like, oh, my favorite color is green. And then the other person's like, oh, mine's purple. And you're like, oh, sorry, we can't be friends because you're part of the purple gang. Step five, make sure you get their name.
What's y'all's names?
Edgar.
I'm Sarah.
Sarah and Edgar, I'm Britt. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
If you don't know their name, how are you gonna be their friends? You're like, hey guy. And then that makes people feel kind of weird because if they're not a guy and you just called them a guy, then they're gonna be like, okay, I guess we can't be friends because this guy just called me a guy even though I'm not a guy. And that's it, that's how you make new friends in today's high school world. Thank you. Namaste.
Hey guys, and welcome to this episode where we are going to be delving into the mind of Cole Brown. So most of you know him as the guy who smashes pumpkins, the guy who eats bad icing, the guy who was dragged off camera by a mysterious figure that nobody knows who it is. So today I'm going to delve inside the mind of Cole Brown and find out if he truly is insane, as his online persona shows all of us. Let's go.
So Cole, you've had a lot of strange things happen in your career.
Yes.
I'm going to be talking to you about some of those things.
Yes.
So the first thing I want to talk to you about is your fascination with pumpkins. So I noticed that you really like smashing pumpkins.
Yeah, I mean, they're a good band. They have some good songs.
No. Not that smashing pumpkins. That smashing pumpkins.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, the pumpkin that you smashed on the table.
I think you're just imagining things.
You know what? Let's move on to the next question.
Okay.
So the next thing I want to ask you about is, was there really anything wrong with that icing?
I mean, no, I think it was just filled with sugar, spice, and everything nice.
Do you think that's what potentially caused your craziness?
I still don't understand what you're asking.
You know what? We'll just move on to the next question,
dude.
Okay. So last Thanksgiving, I remember, and I'm sure your audience will remember too, that you accidentally mistook a pheasant for a turkey. How do you feel about offending the bird culture movement?
I did get blocked on Twitter by PETA for doing that, and I think it's still safe to say that I do get nightmares from that one.
Are you getting insane nightmares?
It was just a pheasant, okay?
It's okay, Cole.
No!
Maybe we need to cut the camera.
No, it's okay. It's just, have you ever thought that maybe you're the crazy one?
There's no way I'm the crazy one here. I can't be imagining all these things. Do you understand? I've never thought of it like that. I need to go.
Dang.
So Wendy and I decided to go on Billboard.com and look at the top hot new music that is popular right now, including an Ariana Grande song, a Post Malone song, and a Halsey song.
Okay, just give me your honest thoughts on this one. She's loaded.
Yeah.
the bop, apparently.
It's a bop, I guess.
It kind of just makes me sad, because I just realize how much money I don't have.
How is this number one?
You know, I don't know, but it's been number one for 8 weeks, is what Billboard says. All right, the next song is called Sunflower by Post Malone and Swally. Wait, I'm gonna look up the lyrics.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna do.
She was all bad, bad, nevertheless.
Yeah.
Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck.
Wreck.
So we know that the lyrics are very touching, incredibly written. Next up, we're gonna be listening to the Halsey song. Anyway, here's the real song. So we hate it. I think this concludes our music review. Until next time, this has been Music Reviews with Haley and Wendy.
I'm Catherine Doyle, and I teach English 1 and 2 here at Clear Falls High School. I am new to Texas. I moved here in June 2018, and before that, I was living in Virginia, and that's where I taught English in middle school. And before teaching in Virginia, I was teaching abroad, and I was fortunate to teach in France, Thailand, and the United Arab Emirates. So as an English teacher, you know it's my goal to first and foremost, hopefully, instill a love of reading with students. As you can see, we have a wonderful assortment of books available to students here at Falls. But it's also to help students to discover their own voices. We each have a unique story that we are able to share with the world. I enjoy working in a place where you can have fun and decorate and enjoy coming to work every day. I really enjoy being in a collaborative environment, so I have enjoyed tremendously working with the English 1 and 2 teams because we really come together to come up with creative lessons to engage the students in our classrooms, and I just like being surrounded by people who, you know, want to try and do their best. For strengths, I'm definitely a positive person that's helped me overcome obstacles in my life, just thinking about the positivity and the bright side of things. And for weaknesses, this is something I've been grappling with for years. I'm habitually late, 10 to 15 minutes, and I am convinced my husband changes all of the clocks in my house and even in my car. I'm a big list person, so I like to figure out, well, what's my goal? What do I have to accomplish? And then from there, kind of break it down into, you know, small measurements of success so that once I know everything I need to do to achieve my goal, I can just check them off my list and, you know, little by little, I'll achieve it. Fun facts about me, I am a pilot, so I started flying when I was 15, and I started in gliders, and then I transitioned into single engine land aircraft, and then I got really into scuba diving, and my husband and I became dive masters when we were teaching in Thailand. So I really like adventurous sports, and this summer we are going to be diving with great whites off the coast of South Africa, so I'm looking forward to that. Chomp chomp.
The 2020 presidential race is going to be a big one, and the DNC has already started rounding up nominees for their candidate. It's gotten pretty crowded, and right now the polls are just a proxy for name recognition. But here's a small corrective measure, and here are some candidates that you may not have heard of before.
Here's Mike Gravel. He's 88 right now. Here he is in 2006, and he was also still an old man. His students filed for this presidency. He did not. However, he did give consent to it. He has not planned to win, he just wants his ideas on direct democracy and non-interventionism put out there on the new Democratic platform.
We also have Pete Buttigieg. He's the mayor of South Bend, Indiana, and if elected, he would be the youngest president ever to be elected at 37 years old and the first openly gay president. He has more experience in politics than the president and more executive experience than the vice president. And because he's young, issues like climate change are issues that will affect him directly instead of thinking of them as issues for the next generation to have to handle. We also have Andrew Yang, a serial entrepreneur running for president in 2020, with the major selling point of the Freedom Dividend, a form of universal basic income, which would be $1,000 a month to every American over 18. His website is the most fleshed out of any of the candidates, and it has detailed information on 72 issues. His focus on the effect of automation on the future of the economy, combined with his appeal to the meme crowd, make him a candidate unlike any other. This has been some of the underdogs from the DNC primary race.
Thank you and have a great day.
That's all for this week's episode of Night Vision. Thanks for tuning in. And remember, it's a great day to be a knight.